The system is still saying, eat, drink dairy. It's a health food. When not only is it not a health food for anyone, it is actively more harmful to Black people and other people of color. Hey friends, Serena here. And today I want to talk to you about something that is very relevant to what is going on in the world around us right now. The last couple of weeks, I've been joining a lot of the Black Lives Matter protests locally and, you know, educating myself and reading a lot about the history of the United States. And I've been amazed, honestly, at how much I've learned that I didn't know. And I actually truly thought before this that I was an educated person. On topics of systemic racism, I've watched 13th, I've watched the film True Justice, I read The New Jim Crow, I've read White Rage. Like, I've read and learned and participated and researched in a lot of things. And to be honest, I have been really shocked at how much I didn't know, at how much Black history in particular I didn't know. But I really wanted to bring it back to food today and share with you why dairy is racist. And I've got three reasons for you. So let's get into it. Number one, lactose intolerance is disproportionate in communities of color. But I'm going to reframe this a little bit. Lactose intolerance makes it seem like being able to digest lactose normally is the default, when in reality, it is not. Around the world, actually, lactose intolerance is really what not being a baby cow means. But more specifically, there's an enzyme, lactase, that allows us to digest lactose. Lactase normally didn't persist past infancy. It's something that we have as babies to digest our mother's milk, and then as we grow up, it's natural for most humans and most mammals to become lactose intolerant. They don't have that enzyme and can no longer digest lactose as an adult. So instead of calling this lactose intolerance, I'm going to call it lactase persistence. And that's the scientific term for people that can digest lactose. So rather than saying that people who can't digest it, they're the problem, they're different, they're abnormal, I'm going to say people that can safely, more or less, digest lactose, they're what's abnormal. Now, the reason this is racist is because who has lactase persistence differs depending on race. Globally, if we look at all white people of European ancestry and descent, about 15% of the population are unable to digest lactose. The rest of that white population are all lactase persistent. So white people have developed a mechanism to continue drinking another species' milk after infancy when they should normally have weaned. But globally, anywhere as high as 75% of the populations of people of color cannot digest lactose, and they do not have lactase persistence. In Black Americans, that number ranges as high as 80% in many communities, and that's pretty consistent when you look at Native Americans, you look at the Latinx population, but these different communities that don't have white European ancestry disproportionately are unable to digest lactose. So that brings me to number two. The second reason that dairy is racist is that at a systemic and institutional level, we are pushing dairy disproportionately on Black people and communities of color, especially in the United States. So let me explain exactly how here. So we have federal nutrition guidelines that recommend what people should be eating, and they currently still say we all should be drinking milk and consuming dairy. And then we have federal programs like SNAP, which is like basically food stamps. We have the federal school food and school lunch programs. We have all of these different public programs that are involved in helping feed people. And those programs so heavily push dairy. And our school system is the best example of this. When I was in public high school, there were, you know, Got Milk posters and Drink Your Dairy and Milk Mustache campaigns all over the public school. And this is true of most public school programs. As part of the school lunch program, one of the requirements for schools to receive federal funding is that they have to offer a glass or bottle of milk to every child at lunch who gets a lunch through them. At the preschool and grade school level, often the requirements are stricter, and some of these go a little bit state by state. often there's a requirement that you have to either get or bring a bottle of milk, or have a doctor's note that allows you to opt out, or an adequate replacement. Who is able to purchase their own lunch or bring their own lunch? It's those that are richer, it's those that are more privileged, it's those that have access to other resources. Hey, editing Serena, hopping on here to clarify the point I'm making. The reason this is systemically and institutionally racist is because the people and communities that most often rely on the federal school lunch program or school breakfast to feed their children are disproportionately communities of color. They are being most fed both the propaganda and the actual dairy and lactose itself. The system is still saying, eat, drink dairy. It's a health food. When not only is it not a health food for anyone, it is actively more harmful to Black people and other people of color. So there's your systemic racism. And I'm gonna keep this kind of brief, but it goes so much deeper than that. Number three is a little bit different, but it's that dairy farms, factory farms, intensive animal confinement operations in general, where are they located? Systemically, these farms and animal intensive operations are not located in white communities. They are not located in upper middle class communities. They're located in the poorest communities where people cannot escape the smell of these operations, the pollution of these operations. And these farms and dairy operations and factory farms in general have so many health problems. Obviously, they're horrible for the animals, and I talk about that a lot, but they're also equally as harmful for the people that work in them, disproportionately people of color and often immigrants, and they're horrible for the people that live around them. Manure is produced, horrible smells from these farms, all of these things that can also affect the people, the health of the people, directly living close by and around them. But that, on the flip side, also makes dairy racist. Now, I just want to clarify, when I say dairy is racist, I mean systemically, our entire system that researches, that promotes, that feeds people, that produces dairy, all of those things, that system is racist in that it disproportionately harms and affects communities of color, and in particular, Black Americans in the United States. And there are a lot of other people that have been speaking out about this, and I'm going to link them below. Dr. Milton Mills, who I've previously interviewed on this channel, he has spoken about this and repeatedly testified to the Federal Nutrition Guidelines Committee about changing our nutrition guidelines and how they are racist. I've linked below a paper that he actually published in a peer-reviewed journal detailing the racism in the Federal Nutrition Guidelines, and I'm gonna link to some other people who have also been speaking out about this. So that is your video for today, and I will be back next week with some more information. See you then.